good morning and happy Friday. It is Try Day Friday here again in the Creative Classroom, and I'm Kim Kesty bringing you some fall projects. I thought, you know what? Getting toward the end of August here, I think it's time to break out the fall dyes and have some fun. So let's take a look at the dye we're using today. We have got this super adorable one. I absolutely love it. It's called Let's Be Frank. And there's actually, it's a great die set because it's almost like two complete ideas here. We've got the Frank, which is of course our little Frankenstein. So these are all the pieces here, and he's got some little nuts and bolts and things here. And then we've got this adorable witch hat and the little witch boots, which is a totally different theme and could make a second project, which I actually think I'm going to do. I think I'm going to make a second video this week. It's going to be super fun. But let's carry on with the Frank portion of this guy. So I'll kind of slide this over. I already took these dies off. And there's really not that much tricky about assembling him, but there is one little tip that I want to walk you through. So let me kind of show you what I got going on here. We've got our Frank head. I've got some little ink. I'm going to ink a little extra on his head here. So I've just got one of our new Distress Oxides. I'm just going to kind of add a little inking, and you know, you kind of want it to be a little like grungy-fied or whatever, because right, isn't that what Halloween's all about? I'm going to come a little bit lower on his forehead because he's actually got a secondary forehead, which is hilarious because it just makes it like super huge and fun. So I've got that already cut out, and I actually already added a little ink on that. So you can see it's just the same thing. You don't necessarily even have to put it on, but boy, does it sure make it fun. So I'm going to put a couple foam squares. And then I just mentioned a little tricky trick. So what I'm going to do is show you these two little dies that cut his little, kind of like his irises of his eye. But in order to get this guy more white behind there, I'm going to actually cut this original die again. So this is the trick. Thought I would just do it for you live here so you can see. Of course, we're going to put our die blade side down, run it through with a white cardstock. And really all I'm trying to capture is the little whites of his eyes, because we want his eyes to be really funny and big and right, all that good stuff. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to come in and see how these are die cut. I guess I can kind of flip them like that so you can see. See how they kind of separate? They've got an actual cut line there. Same with his little mouth. So I'm going to easily be able to come in and just cut these little eyeballs away. Ooh, this is kind of ghoulish, right, Roy? This is like, you're getting into it, man. You're getting into the
cutting out eyeballs? There's something odd about that? I don't know.
Halloween stuff. I love it. Okay, so most of it's going to get covered up by his forehead, but I did just want to tell you because, you know, when I first kind of played with this dye, I'm like, wait, how do you get the eyeballs, like, so super white, you know? So I'm just going to put a dot of glue. And then you just take these little guys you cut out, and you just pop them on top. You've got the lines there, so they're super duper easy to line up. You just do this kind of action. And then, like I said, when you come back with the forehead, that's going to cover up most of his eyes. So don't worry about, like, oh, you got these funky eyes going on, Kim. What's happening? So I actually did all this little gluing earlier. So I'm just going to bring in my pre-glued one. So you can see I cut these out even worse. I was really having fun with those eyeballs. So then you just cut these little, you know, black die cuts and just pop them on. So super easy once you get to that part.
The mad scientist spirit going on there.
Mad scientist, yes. So again, I have a couple of foam squares. I'm going to add a couple more to my little extra forehead height here. Maybe you know this, Roy. I don't know. Is Frankenstein like super smart because he has extra brains, or is he kind of like super not smart because he got his brains cut out?
Well, it depends
on
really what.
Know.
Is this the Mel Brooks story, or is this the Mary Shelley story?
Because okay, so this is we're going to put a poll question up. I feel like this would be a fun poll, like. Is Frankenstein smart, or is Frankenstein not so smart?
Technically, Frankenstein is the professor that made the monster.
Oh, okay, gotcha. I don't know my lore. I just know he's adorable.
Dr. Frankenstein, and this is Frankenstein's monster.
So originally I cut his hair out of green, and I was like, why am I cutting out of green? Obviously he's not going to have green hair. He's going to have black hair, so that was a mistake, but I then went and cut it from black cardstock, but then I remembered we have this really great foam coming out. So guys, this is coming to our website really soon, like in the next couple weeks. But it's just like craft foam. We're calling it like foam to pop up your die cut. So it's, you know, it's similar to the inexpensive craft foam you get, and we're going to sell it in a 10-pack. It's just going to really come in handy for you to create some really fun pop-ups. especially with finer dyes like words and stuff. But I thought, you know what? I'm going for it. I'm getting this foam out and I'm cutting it out of his hair because it just makes it so fun and thick, you know. So put a little bit too much glue on there. All right, so we get his crazy. Oh man, come on. His hair just does it. Makes it so much fun. All right, so again, super easy to cut him out. He's kooky, he's crazy, he's so fun. Now I went ahead and inked a background. I've had it kind of sitting here. So I also used distress inks. I used some broken china around the edge, a little bit of peacock feathers in the middle, and then the faded jeans to make this nice dark around the edge. So I just wanted kind of a great, you know, distressy background. In fact, I could even spritz it with a little water. I think I'm going to. Because, you know, the distress oxides, that's what's so great about them. Because they have the oxide in the label, they're going to react with water. So I'm going to do a little spritz here. Okay, move Frankenstein. And let's kind of watch it as it kind of makes these splotches. I think it'll be even cooler. It'll be even spookier. So I'm going to let that dry for a minute. But in the meantime, let me show you the card base. I just have some great striped pattern paper. This is actually from an FSJ paper pack. And I'll put a link in there. I think we still have it available. And then I'll work on my Frankenstein while this is drying. There's one more fun little accent. See, I'm going to give him, I just cut this out of our purple paper and added a little bit more of that ink on it. I'm going to make him real hunchy, so I'm going to put him really low. But look at his little bolts. So we've got a separate die for those, which I think is totally fun. Here it is. So I'm going to cut it out of a little bit of our mirrored paper. Hopefully this is not going to blind you guys when I cut it. Ah, mirror paper. Probably see all the cameras and everything in it. So I'm going to cut it out of this little mirror paper because I feel like he needs these like shiny metallic bolts, right? I'm telling you, this die is too much fun. All right, pop that on there. Quickly cut out those two guys. Oops. And I realize it's got to be on there the right way. Wait, where'd it go? Ah. The beauty of a live show. You never know what's going to happen. It was coming off my mirror paper. I cut it a little bit too small. All right, there we go. There's our first little bolt. And our second one. I still have a piece of tape on this die. That's why it's not coming out as easy. All right. Let's get in here with a little bit more glue. For each bolt. I do have tweezers. Maybe these will come in handy. Oh my gosh, I love the shininess. So much fun. Totally makes him. All right, I think I'm going to pop him up on this shirt. Because you know what? I can never have too much dimension. Then I might end up putting another one behind the top of his head. Let's see. Oh my gosh, look how fun his shoulders are like up around his ears. Okay, so this is fun. This has just got some fun kind of splotchy going on. I'm going to blot it a little bit just to make sure it's not wet. Then I'm going to put this on the card base. I just left a little bit of the stripes going down each side. I thought it was just a little peak of the green and black. So I'll pop it up with some foam squares. Run that guy right down the middle. So any kind of fun inky background, you guys could have a blast just playing with all kinds of fun different colors. We'll get our Frank over here. I think a tiny bit of his green's popping through, which wouldn't really matter, but we'll trim it a little bit so his black hair is
bald spot?
He has a bald spot. 100%. I love it. Okay, so I'm putting him way down at the bottom of this card. I just think it's hilarious. I'm going to actually pop one doubled up thumb square back here, you know, so it doesn't flip around. Guys, this is the first, like, Halloween-type card I've made this year, so I'm totally, like, getting into it. All right, so I cut a few more dies out from another die that we have, which is a card creator die, and it launched last year, and it's Spiderweb Corners. So this is a great die. I don't actually have the die here. Oh my gosh, this is my second poll question. Do you guys ever lose dies? Because honestly, two of us here in this office have cut this die out, like in the last few days. And all of a sudden I went to look for it before this video and I was like, no one could buy this die. So I'll for sure put a link to it, but it makes us really great corners and you can overlap them like this, or you can build, you know, a slim line by stacking more and more of them up. It's even got a fun little candy connector piece, which makes this longer. So this is a great die. Definitely gonna be one that you guys are gonna have to check out. But I thought these corners, yeah, actually I'm gonna cut off these two middle little connectors because I'm putting this guy in here. So see, I don't need the middle ones. So that's what makes this die so great. It's so versatile. You guys can just kind of make it your own. Put one up here. So we're going to kind of give our little Frankenstein a little frame. One more. Honestly, you guys, we've been like thinking, okay, we're going to get our Try Day Fridays to like a little bit shorter. I just kind of crack up because then we start creating and yeah, they're not that much shorter. But bear with us. So definitely answer my poll if you guys have ever lost a die in your craft room. I have a feeling we're all kind of guilty of that. Okay, just kind of pressing down here and there, make sure my spider webs stay in place. And then I have one more kind of fun thing to show you, which is a little kooky too. Like looking for my other little, oh, everything gets lost. I'm gonna go ahead and do a fun little glimmer sentiment on here. So I have this little glimmer guy popping out here, and this is one of our, again, glimmers from last year, and it has these three adorable little icons. I'll kind of move them over so you guys can see them. And has all these fun little words. So I thought this one, I glimmered it, creep it real, isn't that fun? And I did it with one of our lavender pearl foils. So it just has got the purple and the green, kind of ties everything together. So I'm gonna kind of center it. Actually, I might go a little bit higher. Let's see. Okay, so the kooky thing is this little spider. Now I'm not even kidding. This is not a die cut, it's hilarious. It's this total cheapy little pack of mini spiders I got from, I don't know, the dollar store or something. They're super tiny. You can see you got 50 of them here. Keep an eye out now this time of year when you go to your little, you know, fun little stores. This is just a little plastic little spider. And I just wanted it coming down from the spider web somehow. So I think I'm going to actually end up getting glue gun, but I wanted to kind of show you how I was going to do the little string. So I just got a little black ink pen. Where am I going to put it? I'm going to put it almost what's coming on his shoulders. So probably positioned about there. So then I'll just draw a little, kind of a little spider web wiggling down, right? I wanted to do that before I decided where to put my sentiment. Where should we go? Yeah, I think I'll still overlap it. I kind of like the string coming out behind. Okay. I'm going to put this straight on my grid paper, so I can attempt to get it straight on my card. There we go. So I probably could use our regular glue to go ahead and try to glue it down here, but I think I'm going to wait and just put a little dot of hot glue, because then he'll just stick there, you know, just perfectly. Oh my gosh, it's so cute! So let me trim this guy a little on either end. Put tiny bit more adhesive down there. We'll see if it sticks. Oh no, I think it's sticking. So look at this guy. How fun is that? I'll move this glimmer. And again, I'll make sure we link to all the products. But we've got our little spider. I'm gonna hot glue him. Got our amazing Frank with his little metallic bolts there, our little card creator spider webs. It all just comes together. It's so much fun. I'm super excited. So I hope that you enjoyed that little kind of quick, not so quick Frankenstein card. Again, be sure to tune in and be sure if you're on YouTube to like our channel and subscribe so you don't miss anything. I'm gonna actually be back later today because I can't resist. I'm gonna make that little witch card. So we're gonna kind of extend this Friday, Friday today. I think it's gonna be super fun. So stay tuned. We'll see you later on today and have a great, fun crafting day.